Let's analyze an illustration of oscillating charge ball. Here we can see that it is saying two small identical balls lying on a horizontal plane are connected by an ideal spring. One ball is fixed at point O and the other is free. The balls are given equal charges, as a result of which the spring length increases twofold. And here we are required to find the change in frequency of the system due to charging of balls. Here, if we first draw the situation, here you can see there is a horizontal plane. And on this horizontal plane, there are two balls. One is fixed at point O and other is kept free. And these are connected by a spring, which is right now in its natural length. And if the balls are provided with equal charges, obviously due to repulsion between the balls, the spring length will increase. And we are required to find the change in frequency of system due to charging of balls. So if we talk about the natural frequency of oscillations. So here we can see natural frequency of oscillations. This can be given as omega, which is root of K by M. This, I hope all of you have studied in a simple harmonic motion. If you are not able to recall, go through all the videos of simple harmonic motion. So here, if the ball is of mass M and the spring is of force constant K, the natural frequency of oscillation is root of K by M. Here, if we charge the two balls with equal charges Q and Q, then due to repulsion, the equilibrium position shifts away from the natural length. And we are given that the spring length increases twofold. If its natural length is L, it will change to 2L. And this will be the new equilibrium position as per the situation given in the problem. And here, for this new equilibrium position, we can balance the forces to get a relation among the parameters. So we can write at new equilibrium position, we use, this will be the spring force on a spring will be KL, and the repulsive force between the two charges will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by 2L whole square. So this is our one equation we are getting for equilibrium position. Now from this equilibrium position, we further displace the ball by a small distance x, and we calculate the restoring force onto it. Then we can write, after displacing the ball by x, a restoring acceleration of a ball is, here we can write the equation of motion for it, because after further displacing by x, the spring elongation changes to L plus x. So inward force on the ball will be K times L plus x minus the Coulombian force it is experiencing is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by 2L plus X whole square. And this should be equals to MA, where M is the mass of ball and A is its acceleration. So this is the equation of motion. We simplify this, you can see we are getting it as KL plus KX minus, it can be written as Q square by, here I can take this 2L common out, so this will be 4L square, so this will be 16 pi epsilon naught L square, and here the remaining term I can write as 1 plus x by 2L power minus 2. I have taken this denominator and numerator, which is equals to MA. And here x is very small, I can apply binomial over here and open this bracket and neglect the higher orders of x. So I'll be getting KL plus KX minus Q square by 16 pi epsilon naught L square. and this will be 1 minus x by L, and that is equals to MA. If I continue and simplify this relation, then using this equation 1, you can see Q square by 16 pi epsilon naught L square is equals to KL. So here you can see the value of this KL and this 1 gets cancelled out because these two terms are equal as per equation 1. And this Q square by 16 pi epsilon naught L cube can be written as K. So here I can see I'm getting is the final result after this step. I can write Q square by 16 pi epsilon naught L cube. I can write as K if I take this L over here. So this will be 2kx is equals to MA. So here the acceleration I'm getting is 2k by m into x. So if this is the restoring acceleration of ball, I can put a negative sign over here because of restoring in nature. So here negative sign we have taken for a restoring acceleration as it is opposite to the direction of displacement. And if we compare over the general differential equation or SHM, which is minus omega square x, we can get the value of omega as acceleration is proportional to x. It signifies that it is executing SHM. And on comparing, we are getting the value of omega as root of 2k by m. And we already studied that natural oscillation frequency of ball here is root of k by m. And after charging, it is root 2k by m. If we take this as omega naught, this can be written as root 2 times omega naught. So here we can write that frequency changes to root 2 times after charging. And that's the answer to this problem.